Hey YouTube, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. I recently bought a Ring indoor camera. My plan with this is to put it in my garage and use it as a security camera. So basically I'm going to be mounting it on the back wall, as you can see here. It will be facing out towards the front of my garage. And basically if I get motion alerts, especially at night or during the day when I'm tending to be at work or maybe out, then that could be an intruder. And as a result, I'm going to look at that motion alert in more detail. I might make use of the motion snooze feature as well, so daytime during the weekends when I tend to go in my garage, I won't actually get alerted to motion because that might not be useful, but at all other times I'll listen to the motion alerts in case it is an intruder. So that's my general plan, and as you can see I've also got power in my garage, so that'll work really well, other than the one fundamental flaw in my plan, which is I don't have any internet in my garage. My previous video, however, covered 7 different ways of how to get internet in an outbuilding when you don't previously have internet there, and I spoke through a few different methods that you can use. The method which I decided upon for myself is to use power line adapters. So the way the power line adapters work is they plug into a wall socket and they have Ethernet ports on the top or the bottom. And basically inside my house, what I'm going to do is I'm going to plug this into the wall socket near my internet router. I'm going to plug an Ethernet cable into the top and then another one into the back of my internet router. What I'll then do, I'll go over to my garage and I will plug a similar power line adapter into a wall socket in my garage. And then I will plug this again into an Ethernet port. And from there, I will plug that into one of the LAN cables in my router. In the garage. Okay, and what that actually does is these power line adapters use the electricity and the electrical cables in your house and running into your garage to actually provide you with internet on the other end. So this is a really nice method because you don't have to run loads of cables all throughout your house, and this is also quite cheap because you're reusing your existing cabling and your existing house's internet, so you don't have to go out and get another internet plan. Once this is all hooked up, which should be fairly straightforward, the last thing I need to do is sort out my internet router so that it can actually provide backup internet and act as an access point in my garage. The way I'll do this is I'm going to use an old router that I have from when I upgraded to my internet package and hence had a new router. So I'm going to get a router, I'm going to do a factory reset on it, and then there's two main things that you need to do. The first thing is you need to turn off DHCP on your router. The reason for that is that DHCP is the technology which allocates and manages IP addresses of devices connected to your internal network. But I don't want DHCP running on this router in my garage because that would mean I have two DHCP services running and they would clash. So I need to turn DHCP off on this router and then I would just have the one DHCP service running on my main router. The next thing I need to do is make sure that the IP address or the default gateway of this router is different to my main one. If they're the same thing, which they will be, or very likely will be if it's the same manufacturer of the router, if they're the same, then the IP addresses will clash and this won't work or it will produce unexpected results. So I'm going to go and do this now. I won't show how to actually turn off DHCP and change the default gateway on this particular router because your router will probably be different. And even if you have a BT router, the ways that you actually change things inside the admin console will vary per version. What I will do, I'll put details in the description for this particular type of BT HomeHub, but in general, the best thing to do if you want to follow this process is to actually Google how you turn off DHCP and how you change the default gateway for your particular router. So to get started, I plugged in the router to my laptop after doing a factory reset. I disabled DHCP, I changed the default gateway, and I also had to disable the firewall, which I hadn't expected to do. But then at that point, the router was ready to go and ready to test. So in a separate point in my house, I plugged into the home network via the Ethernet cable you can see on the left, and then I connected to the router wirelessly, over Wi-Fi, and it worked fine. I could surf the internet and manage the router. So I then moved on to getting the power line adapter set up. So you can see here in my living room, I've got it plugged in, and I got an Ethernet cable going down into one of the LAN ports of my router. You can see on the right here, this one. So that's plugged in. And then if I just put my router up, it's still rebooting. and it's now success, and the power line adapter's working, and this is part of the home network, at least inside it is. And you can see some lights on the router itself, on the power line adapter saying that. And then in the garage, I've done the same thing. I plugged in the power line adapter here. You can see the light showing it's successful. And then got an Ethernet cable coming down and into the back of this BT router. Now this BT router is flashing purple. That's actually normal with BT routers. Although it's actually set up and it's a working access point, wireless access point, it just flashes purple because it's not connected to the internet. Also, please excuse all the dust. I've been cutting pavement slabs in my garage and I'm cleaned up. But there we are, that's ready to go. That looks to be all working, despite the purple flashing light. So the next thing to do is test out. So while in my garage, I went onto my phone, I went to connections and Wi-Fi. I'd previously already connected to it. But just to demonstrate, I turn on, I connect, auto connect rather, to the Wi-Fi network, the access point from the router, and it says it's connected, which is a great sign. So then the next thing I do is go on to the internet and I make sure that I can refresh, which is good. Go to a brand new website as well, and it also loads. So that's brilliant. It shows that the wireless access point in my garage is working and I now have Wi-Fi in my garage. Okay, so the next step is actually to set up my Ring indoor cam. You can see the box here. So I'll just open it up and you can see the Ring indoor cam there. I'll just take the little blue instruction label off. So also in the box, in addition to the indoor cam, is this blue mounting kit and power supply information. So let's go into there now. And you've got the power cable and a few other stuff came out there as well, but that's fine. They're just different power adapters for different countries. In addition, you've also got this mounting kit for the Ring cam if you want to wall mount it, which I do, which comes onto the back bracket here, which I'll look at later on. But for now, what I'll do, I'll put on the UK power adapter, because obviously I'm in the UK. Put that, plug that in, and then in the back here, you can see where this goes. So I'll just unwind this cable. You get around 2 or 3 meters worth of cable as well, which is pretty generous. So I can actually run this to the middle of my garage, which is quite nice, to the middle wall of my garage, without any extension leads. So that's quite nice. Tangled mess at this stage. Please bear with me. Please also ignore all the dust on my fridge freezer as well. Right, let's plug that in. Actually, it's a chest freezer, but that's not important. Right, so let's plug that in now. Let's put the power on. And right now, to begin with, nothing actually happens, and that's because you've actually got to click the power button up here on the top. You can see there. And once that's clicked, the blue light comes on and it says,
"Say hello to Rick. Follow the instructions in the Ring app to continue."
Okay, so I'll now switch to the Ring app. So here it is, the Ring app. I'll go into that on my phone. I've already previously got a Ring device, so I've already got an account, but if you haven't, you'd have to set that up. But in this case, I'll go to the menu and set up a device. Now that's the camera I want, so I'll go to security cams, and I need to scan the QR code on the back of the device. So it's worth doing this before you wall mount the device. So yes, I want it at that location, which I'll just blank out my home address. I'll give it a name as well. I'll say garage. Okay, and at this point, it's a case of just following the instructions and your Ring camera will be speaking to you as well. So here it firstly says, let's plug in your indoor cam, which is all done. I've waited 30 seconds. Let's continue. Wait for your stick-up cam to enter setup mode, which you'll see by the blue flashing light. Because it's flashing, I'll obviously click that. I need GPS on my phone, so just turn that on. Let's continue. Okay, so it's now set connecting to the Wi-Fi, which probably won't work because my Ring Doorbell Pro is set up on a different Wi-Fi network. There we are. So that's what my Wi-Fi Pro is connected on. So it's saying, do I want to connect to that? Which I wouldn't be able to because I can't connect to it from my garage. So I'll click on no. I'll go to my Wi-Fi access point that I looked up before, which is the first one at the top. It'll be connected on 2.4 gigahertz because the Ring indoor cam doesn't support that. So just skipped ahead there, but I entered my Wi-Fi password. Okay, and at this point, it's just connecting the Ring indoor cam to that Wi-Fi network. As you can see, it takes a few moments. This is not too long though. This is almost there. Brilliant. There we are. So it's now connected to the Wi-Fi network and the app can see that. And you can see straight away Alexa is connected the garage to the Alexa skill as well, which is great. I also want snapshot capture, which I'll turn on and set up outside of this video. So there we are, brilliant. It's all set up, which is great. At this stage then, there's some more instructions that can show you, such as showing you how to wall mount, which I'll look at later, so I'll skip the tutorial. Under additional settings, it asks you, do you want to share the device, which I'll go ahead and do, but I'll skip ahead. There you are. So I sent an invite to my wife. Linked devices is also really cool. So if motion is detected in my garage, it can automatically start recording in my Ring Doorbell Pro and any other Ring devices I've got, and vice versa as well. So it's a really nice feature. Again, I'll set that up offline. So for now, I'll just skip ahead. And then obviously I've got a 30-day trial of my Ring Protect plan. It'll keep bugging me, but I'll wait until the end of the trial before I actually pay for the plan. Okay, so I'll go back in. And there we are, you can see the garage at the bottom. Right now, you can't see the feed, and that's because my Ring indoor cam is still in sort of setup mode, as you can see. And there's a little message that just says it's currently updating. It takes a few minutes, so don't worry about that. I'll skip ahead, because I randomly received a motion alert in my Ring camera, which suggests that the camera's set up. And there you are, you can see some dodgy person in the garage. There is, again, some dodgy thief. Let's ring the police. Oh, no, sorry, that's me. But anyway, you can see it actually works. And if we go to live as well, we should get the video feed from my garage, which is using my Wi-Fi access point. There we are. That's brilliant. So again, you've got this dodgy thief. We really need to ring the police on that dodgy guy. But anyway, that's all set up, which is brilliant. And I can also move the Ring indoor cam around to actually get a better view of my garage. Hello, that's me. It's 30 degrees Celsius, so I'm absolutely baking and warm while doing this. Hence all the sweat, sorry about that. But anyway, the point of this is that I can actually move my camera around now and actually see the best position for my Ring indoor cam. But other than that, it's all set up, which is brilliant. Now that I've determined the best place for it, I can start wall mounting. So the first thing I'm gonna do is remove the bracket at the bottom just by unscrewing it, as you can see here. And it comes off quite easily. And then basically in the back instead, you can insert this in the back. So you've got to remove the screw from here. So I'll just do that as well. Okay, so with that removed, you can actually now insert this. Well, you can firstly take off the back bracket. It'll go onto the wall. You can see there, it'll go onto the wall. And then the other part will actually hook in over it. So that'll be attached to your Ring camera. So in essence, that'll connect in from there. Okay, so you can actually see now, I'll put the back thing onto there now, and I'll actually just screw this back in there. So again, this is going to wall mount mode instead. So I'll just screw that back in, that's attached. Using a drill's not really the best way of doing it. It's easier just to use a screwdriver, but there we are. I was lazy because it was really warm. Okay, so at that point, that's attached and it's nice and secure. So I'll put the power cable back in and just leave that. Next thing I want to do is actually attach the wall bracket after measuring up. So I'll drill a couple of holes for this. I'm actually using the Ring. I'm going to use the actual anchor provided by Ring. Although the wall anchors aren't that good, I thought it's good enough. So with those holes done, I'll zoom in on them now. But before I do that, sorry, I'll just put these wall anchors in, I'll just hammer them in. Yeah, brilliant hammering work, 10 out of 10 there. And the other one as well. Okay, brilliant. So I've zoomed in now, you can actually see with the pencil, you can see where the wall anchors are. Not particularly straight, to be honest, level, but it'll do the job, to be honest, because you can actually move around the Ring camera at the end, which we'll look at, so it doesn't have to be completely level, the actual screw holes, thankfully. Okay. So I'm just starting to put that in place, and then I'm just gonna, I've put some screws in, and I'm just gonna tighten the screws now. The back bracket. Okay, and that's pretty much there now, so that's the back bracket of the ring cam. To be honest, it doesn't need to be that secure, because obviously if anyone was to nick this, I would get a lot of footage of them actually stealing it. And the ring indoor cam is quite cheap anyway, but either way, it's attached to the wall and it's solid, it's not going to fall down, and the ring cam just clicks on top, which you can see there, so it clicks in and clicks down to secure it. And then, as you can see here, you can actually move the indoor cam around, you can rotate it up, you can rotate it sideways, you can get a really good field of vision, and it's really flexible in terms of exactly what you're able to see. Okay, in terms of the wire, you can just see it going along there. Obviously, I'll probably tack it to the wall or put in trunking, like you can see there. But right now, I'll just leave it there. You can see the blue light, meaning it's in recording mode. Finally, I just want to test things out and verify that everything works. So I'm going to jump into the Ring app here. I'll go into the garage and just tap to go live. It takes a few seconds. But there we are. It's live. There we are. You can see me now recording whilst also watching the feed on my camera, which is confusing. Hello, hi. Okay, so you can see the sort of video feed here, you can see the sort of quality, and I'm just adjusting it up and down to my liking. So you can see there's a very good sort of recording quality here. Obviously there's a lot of light coming from the garage, the garage door that's open. But other than that, you know, it's good quality of recording, and you can make out the person in the garage. I'll turn the light off, which makes it a bit harder to see me, but let's test out night vision mode now. So I'll shut the garage door, and quite quickly the infrared sensors detect this low light, and at this point I realize that I'm stuck because I can't see in the dark, so I'm trying not to trip over and look like an utter idiot. There we are, I'm finding my way. Yeah, I'm not dead, I haven't fallen over, that's brilliant. Okay, cool, yeah, there we are. Hello, yeah. Brilliant, well done, you found your way to the camera. On this note, if I seen this clip on my Ring camera, I would instantly ring the police, but thankfully I know that this is me and no one else. But you can see anyway, the night vision is really good. You can see the quality there. It's in black and white, but you can see me really well, and hence I could see an intruder. Obviously I open the garage door and light floods. You can see the light flooding, and it's a bit harder to see me, or it's very hard to see me. But to be honest, most thefts would take place at night with night vision, so I have no problems about the actual quality of the recording here. And even then, I can see me here, and combined with my ring indoor, my ring doorbell, I'm not too concerned about the quality of the footage here. So overall, yeah, I'm really happy with the result. Quick final point is, in the box you get a ring warning sticker, as you can see. Now, I could stick it to my garage somewhere visible from the street, such as there. Or I could throw it away completely, because some people say not to advertise your security system. Or I could put it down here, right by the lock, so if the burglar comes and tries to tamper with the lock, they'll see this. My own opinion on this sticker debate is that Ring cameras are quite obvious, as are Nest cameras. You may as well put a warning sticker, because it's quite obvious to a thief anyway that you've got a Ring camera. Okay, so this is my garage. I've got some CCTV up already, but I've also now got this Ring protection as well, as you can see from this, which should hopefully act as a deterrent for any would-be thieves. Hey YouTube, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I want to walk you through the whole steps of how I set up my Ring indoor cam, considering that I didn't have internet in my garage already, which was always going to be a challenge because I had to decide how to get internet there. In the end, obviously, as you've seen, I decided on using power line adapters with a router to create a wireless access point. I was a little bit unsure about whether the power line adapters would work fully, but to be honest, it's worked really well so far. It's already been a week that I've had this set up for, and I've had no issues at all. I've been able to go into my Ring app and look at the footage of my Ring camera in the garage with no issue whatsoever. It's always worked really well. I'll still keep an eye on it, but so far I'm really happy with the solution, and I'm happy with the camera in my garage as well. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.